brought to you by Penguin.
The Old Testament, according to Spike Milligan. Read by the author.
The creation, according to the trade unions. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. This was due to a malfunction at Lot's Road power station. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light, but Eastern Electricity Board said he would have to wait until Thursday to be reconnected. And God saw the light, and it was good. He saw the quarterly bill, and that was not good. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And so he passed his GCSE. And God said, "Let there be a firmament." And God called the firmament heaven, free phone 9386. And God said, "Let the waters be gathered together until one place, and let the dry land appear." And in London, it went on the market at £600 a square foot. And God said, "Let the earth bring forth grass." And the earth brought forth grass. And the Rastafarians smoked it. And God said, "Let there be lights in heaven to give light to the earth." And so it was, except over England, where there was heavy cloud and snow on high ground. And God said, "Let the seas bring forth that that hath life, flooding the market with fish fingers, fish burgers, and grade 3 salmon." And God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful, multiply, and fill the sea, and let the fowl multiply on earth, where Prince Charles and Prince Philip would shoot them." And God said, "Let the earth bring forth cattle and creeping things." And there came cows and the BBC Board of Governors. And Lord said, "Let us make a man in our own image." But woe, many came out like spitting image. On the seventh day, God ended his work. But Datsun of Coventry workers went on to time and a half, and God rested from all his work with the complete backing from Arthur Scargill and the miners. God blessed the seventh day, as did all the Pakistani corner shops. And the Lord formed man of the dust of the ground, and he breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. It was done privately and not on the national health. The Lord planted a garden in Eden, and there he put the man he had formed, and he sold the idea to BBC as Gardener's World. And out of the ground the Lord grew every tree that was pleasant to the sight. But he had not reckoned on the weather forecast from Michael Fish, and so they were all blown down in the hurricane. And the Lord took man and put him in the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it, subject to compulsory purchase by Brent Council. The Lord said of every tree of the garden, "Thou mayest freely eat," but he was apprehended at the checkout and forced to pay. "But the tree of knowledge thou shalt not eateth, or thou shalt surely die, due to crop spraying with DDT. And the Lord said, "It is not good that man should be alone." He caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam, which the shop steward penalized him for during working hours, deducting a day's pay. The Lord took one of Adam's ribs and made a woman, and brought her unto the man, which immediately qualified him for a common law wife allowance. And they were both naked, the man and his wife, and they were not ashamed. However, at Bow Street, they were charged with indecency. Now, the serpent was more subtle than beasts of the field, he said unto the woman, Come and eat the fruit of this tree. Woman said, Nay, if we eat or touch it, we die. And the serpent said, Fear not, they are not from South Africa. Whereupon she ate and gave of it her husband. And the eyes of them were both opened, and they knew they were both naked. And Adam said to her, Stand back. I don't know how big this is going to get. And the Lord God called unto Adam, Where art thou? And Adam said, I art here. Both Adam and Eve's eyes were opened, and they saw they were naked, and they sewed on fig leaves, one for Eve and 180 for Adam. The Lord said, Who told thee thou wast naked? And Adam said, I could see it all hanging down. Hast thou eaten of the apple, said the Lord? Yea, Eve gave it to me, said Adam, Granny Smith. Woman, said the Lord, what hast thou done? And Eve said, I haven't done anything. I've only just got here. And the Lord said unto the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly thou shalt go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of your life. This is victimization, said the serpent. I shall appeal to the RSPCA. Unto Adam and Eve the Lord God made coats of skins, and verily they looked terrible. You could still see it all. And Eve saw Cain and said, Lo, I have gotten a man from the Lord. And she got another son, and together they were called Cain and Abel. And it came to pass that Cain rose up and slew Abel very badly. And the Lord said, Hello, 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 what's going on here? And the Lord set a mark upon Cain. It was on his right forearm, and it said, Manchester United. And Cain went out from Eden to the land of Nod. But there was a curse on the land. It was called the Nationwide Building Society. And Adam lived 130 years after a course of male hormones. He was lifted on and off, and lo, he begat a son, Seth, who went on to begat many sons and daughters and won the Queen's Award for Industry. And it came to pass, men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and lo, there were many queues for hip operations and standing only on the tube. And the sons of God saw the daughters of men, and they were fair. And they took them wives, all of which they chose. But woe, the sleeping arrangements were dodgy. The Lord looked upon the earth, and lo, it was corrupt with nightmare on Elm Street 3. He saith unto Noah, Build an ark, and two of every animal of the earth thou shalt take in it. So Noah let the animals in, and lo, Noah and his family were soon up to their necks in it. And Noah's wife said, For God's sake, someone open a window. And Lord made it rain 40 days and nights, and the world was flooded, all except England, where they had a drought and a hosepipe ban. And the rain and waters prevailed upon the earth 150 days, and woe, cricket was cancelled at the oval. And it came, the waters abated, and Noah sent forth a raven. Yea, he went forth and stayed forth. Noah then sent forth a dove, and lo, it returned with an olive leaf plucked off. Noah himself was pretty plucked off. Noah waited 7 days, and he sendeth off the dove yet again. But this time it returneth not, having been shot on the glorious 12th. And when the land had dried, Noah lifted the cover off the ark and let it all out. And Noah built an altar for the Lord with a DIY and gave a burnt offering. But the Lord was angry and said, "This offering is burnt." So Noah.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.